Hello everyone, this is Pomom, bringing you part 54 of my Fire Emblem Awakening Let's Play. We have a lot of support to do. When I say a lot, I mean a lot. Everyone except for Frederick, and Frederick doesn't have anyone left to support in the team, has at least one support, so grab yourself something to drink, because this is going to be long. I think Super Saiyan has like, yeah, 4 supports. So, okay. Let's begin with Subasa Laurent, because I think Laurent has various supports too. Subasa. Hello, Laurent. How about work, I presume? Yep, just trying to get some of these chores done. You look exhausted, but a drone haggard and deadly pale. Thanks. I guess I have been feeling a little worn out. Oops. Now you can barely walk without stumbling. They're simply masses. You have worked yourself to the very brink of total exhaustion. Oh, don't exaggerate, Lauren. I just slipped on a pedal. You're not exaggerating. You're looking more recent than human lately. It's just that I have so much to do. Everyone is counting on me. That's why you must trust your friends. And in me. Allow me to shoulder at least a share of your burden. Laurent, I respect you tremendously, both as a tactician and as a friend. But in this one area, I believe your judgment is suspect, at best. You must face the facts and allow me to assist you with your work. Well, if you feel that strongly about it, I suppose I can't really say no. Finally, I'll bring a concession of you. Now, promise me you won't work so hard. Alright, Laurent, I promise. Okay. Nice and tame. Who else has multiple supports? I think Na has. Yeah, Nakelam, for example. This music. Okay. Nah. Hi. Why, hello, father. What can I do for you? About the other day when you said you were used to disappointment. What exactly do you mean by that? Oh, that I was talking about growing up in my foster home. Wait, you mean no one wasn't around to raise you? No, I never knew either of my parents. I was sent to live with the family of one of my father's soldier friends. But my new family wasn't very welcoming to their semi-human mongrel foster child. Don't say that. I soon learned that I'd have to work hard to fit in and survive in a new home. And of course, before I was asked, I helped defend the house for more than a reason. I thought if I could make myself useful, they would stop hitting me. I mean, how could they resent a child that always helped and never asked for anything? But they never accepted me, I just learned to deal with disappointment. I had no friends, no one to talk to. I was utterly alone. And I never once mentioned how much I missed my father and mother. I didn't even ask when would they come back for me. When I arrived here, I wanted to find out everything I could about them. That's why I kept asking so many questions. I'm making you angry. I'm sorry. I've been bland this whole time. I'll tell you anything you want to know, even the embarrassing story of our cross. If you're ever feeling lost or sad, I'll be right there for you. As long as I'm around, you won't ever be lonely again. Truly? Do you really mean it? Oh, thank you, father. Not at all, Nada. Now, tell me, what do you want to know? Let's start with how you proposed to mother. What do you say? What did you do? I want to hear everything, and I don't leave out even the smallest detail. Alright, well, as you know, your mother has always looked young. That was a nice one. Okay, unexpectedly nice, even. Yeah, let's do this. You look very low today. If you're here to gloat, get on with it and leave me alone. 0 out of tricks specs, I got nothing. 0 silk, nada ixnay. I don't even have any more sweets to go again. Surely, you're completely out. I said you have a secret stash. Read it last night, cleaned it out in an enabling I did. I've never been this long without sugar, I think I'm having heart palpitations. Yeah.
You misunderstand. I was speaking not of sweets, but of cartridges. Oh, well, you bled me dry on those two. Interesting. Perhaps think you could think up new ones. Oh yeah, sure. I just reach down and pull them out of my head. Look, why are you so interested in my cartridges anyway? Not like I ever managed to fool you. It is a difficult reason to put into words, but I shall attempt it. I find our competition to be stimulating, almost thrilling in point of fact. My senses were heightened like never before. It was a truly zesty experience. Fuck off. I hate her so much. Oh, you seem pretty bored to me. I assure you, I was not. Your enthusiasm for the game was quite infectious. My skin jagged, my heart raced, and I noted a dozen other signs of excitement besides.
So there is a bit of passion behind that logical story of yours?
That would be a fair proposition, yes?
Oh yeah, that passion just comes running through. Tell you about specs. If you like playing that match, I'll try to conjure up some more tricks, alright? May us have a couple of ideas. Well, mostly harmless. Yeah, let's finish with Miriam already. Mother, may I ask your opinion on a new creation?
That? A ground parcel, safety bound. What is it?
The derivative product of the new discoveries you made in color frames. They made for such a strange insight, I was moved to explore possible populations. I've packed substances that produce flames of green, blue, and yellow inside. If detonated in midair, it should yield a dazzling display of color.
I cannot imagine such an experiment would elucidate any hidden truths.
I will admit it lacks in practical uses.
But it would surely illuminate the sky in a breathtaking manner.
That was the intent. On the next clear night, I thought we might assemble the camp and give it a test.
Just as critical as the quantity of knowledge one amasses is how one employs it. Imagination is something that I lack. I greatly envy such dynamism. Lauren, will you permit me to assist you on this experiment?
I would be honored, Mother. Okay. This is interesting because I seem to remember, is it Orochi and Laszlo's support in Revelations? I can only get it in Revelations because they are from Nora and Hoshido. I think they talk about making, you know, fireworks, and because Inigo's, like, because Laszlo is Inigo and Laszlo, Selena, and Odin supports in Fates have a lot of references to Awakening. I feel like this may be a reference to maybe Lauren teaching Inigo how to make fireworks. Just something I wanted to drop there. Okay. I think we are down to single support for each person. There you are, Tsubasa. Are you ready for our next discussion on how to properly enjoy armor? Kill, you don't enjoy armor, you love armor. You are consumed by it, infatuated, maybe even obsessed? Obsessed? Me? Well, it's not necessarily a bad thing, of course. It's just hard to talk with you about anything else and... No, it's fine. I get it, Tsubasa. I'm boring you, aren't I? I start talking about armor and then I just won't shut up. Armor this, armor that, blah 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 blah. You hate me now, don't you? You hate the very sight of me. Kiel, that's absurd. I enjoy your company very much. And I don't hate armor either, you know. You're just so serious about it. I mean, how did this happen? Where did this mad obsession even come from? You want to know why I care about armor so much, Tsubasa? It's because armor was my only friend. I don't understand. My future, humanity was on the verge of extinction, risen around the land. My life depended on my arm. And after my comrades and parents were dead and gone, it yet protected me. In the end, it was all I have left. It was constant, it never deserted. thanks to my armor that I am still alive today to talk about. You see now, armor isn't just gear. It's a friend to whom I owe my life. But that was then. Now you have something better that you can rely on. Better armor, you mean? No, ask Kiel, your friends. Look around the camp, don't you see how many people here care about you? When we all stand together, nothing can possibly harm you. You make a convincing case to us. But I don't simply want to be protected. I want to protect my comrades in return. No one would ask any less of you, because we all feel the same. We all watch out for each other. Now that's the best kind of armor there is. Cheesy. No. Kelandona? Okay, Kelandona. Look, Tonella, I heard through the grapevine that the Bilberry Serpent. Have you been serving them to everyone in camp? With brown sugar and cream, everyone loves them. I thought that I had lost and lost, but everyone got them up so fast. Land sakes, it was gone before I knew it. Well, that's great. It made me promise to serve more once I had a new crop. I think the bushes are there already. The berries are kind of ripe. Hold on, let me try. Sorry, Donnie, this bush need another few weeks at least. Alright then, suppose I should cool my heels for a spell. I'm mighty glad I spoke to Calam the genius before collecting it. I told you I'm not that clever, I just happened to. I wish I had half your brains. You remember the plants that what was all rupian dying? Where I changed the soil like you said and got me a bumper crop. I weigh your coppers to pebbles your pan mom miss having you around the farm. Most days they didn't know I was there. They never asked my opinion or anything. Well, that's about the dumbest thing I've ever done here. You don't. You're the first person who's ever appreciated my advice. Well then, appreciate it. You got a very soothing out of your ears. So you'll stick around to teach me more stuff, right? Well, sure. I'll try to help however I can. But isn't it a strange thing teaching you about farming and not fighting? Heck no. I'm already planning for the peace to come. When those travels are over, honest folk are going to return to their farms. We need to be ready so we can bring life to this here land. Perhaps when the time comes, I could help them. You do that too for me? Gosh, thanks, Kalam. And it's a deal. First, we finish this war. Then we plant enough bilberries to make five for everyone. Nice. Okay, they are starting to disappear. Stal, Tsubasa. What he said. What's wrong, Stal? You sound a bit dumb.
Well, I apparently needed to practice then. It was supposed to be a sign of relief. Some friends were in a bit of a row, but I managed to calm the waters.
You're always helping doing things like that, aren't you? Helping others with their problems? Most of us are too busy looking after ourselves, but you always found it.
Yeah. Well, in a way, but for my own sake, travel folks make me uncomfortable. When I see friends fighting, my first instinct is to intervene and restore the peace.
And now you're acting humble and deflecting the praise from yourself.
Sorry, is that annoying?
Not annoying, no, but you should stand up for yourself from time to time too. For example, you could start by telling people that today is your birthday.
You knew?
I found out, yes, but not from you. Friends should be able to tell each other that much. Or maybe raging around us, but that doesn't mean we can't have fun sometimes.
I suppose.
Spend so much time looking after other people that someone has to look after you. I've decided that someone is going to be me. So here, have a couple of fried fish cakes in honor of your birthday.
Oh, my favorite. Thanks, Tsubasa, you're a true friend.
And Estelle eats food. Bike Maribel. Okay.
Maribel, lady, would you mind giving this to Chrome?
An apple? But I lost our bet.
Yeah. Right, that's why I had you join. Why you had to join me for a drink in the common ale house. But we get settled. This is just me having a change of heart. Don't worry, as far as I got it yesterday, paid for it with Thunderscore and everything.
Then, am I to assume you have renounced your gambling ways?
Well, I wouldn't go so far as to say that tomorrow's another day, hey?
Fair enough. Still, I must admit it, it was quite interesting to dine with the masks. When I ended up with an A+, well, perhaps by losing, I actually won now.
Ah. You really didn't mind slamming it down with us common filth, eh?
It was an absolutely fascinating experience. All the small folk are each other so very different. I didn't even mind the smell after a time.
Yeah, it didn't exactly go like I planned. So I teach you a lesson about how people take looking down your nose at them, but after 10 minutes you have them all charmed. They love you like a sister. Maybe you ain't such a snob after all.
Perhaps not. Oh, but you simply must take me there again sometime to promise me back.
Sure, I guess.
Splendid. It's a date. Now I must find the Grom and deliver this apple.
The bacon wrong often, but maybe this time I could be. We misjudge that woman.
Okay. I like how the support was about Maribel acting kind of as an intermediate person to Grom, and she's, you know, married to Grom, so it all makes sense. Do I have both? Okay. And Sarah Brady.
Sarah.
Greetings, society member number 2. Are we done with today's procurement round?
No.
Stop calling me that, eh? Yeah, hold on. Still don't see why I'm always the one that's buying yank. I mean, what have you been doing all this time, aside from nagging around?
I've been very busy, I'll have you know. I've been assembling everything you bought into decoration for the tent. See?
Huh? Actually, that doesn't look terrible. It's a bit gaudy, isn't it?
No, it isn't. It's elegant and sophisticated. We are a society, after all. Not for the gold, silk, and lanterns. It looks finesse. You have a name to live up to. If it all happens to be a hero over the top, it will just make people all the more jealous.
Hero, this thing is a full weak shop over the top, sir.
What? Okay.
Can barely see in here. All the gold leaf is blinding me.
Well, get over it, cats. I don't see why you always have to complain.
Say, contrarian to her partner is in a contrarian society. Like, I've already spent way more time and money on this than I thought I would.
Would you stop your grumbling already? Oh, Brady, those teacups are darling. I didn't know you had an age for those.
Well, you know.
Why did you just have the seller choose them for you? Oh, please, don't try to deny it. I can read you like a book. Anyway, back to sewing. Won't be long now. I know it's difficult, but try to contain your excitement.
Stubborn as a mule, as always. Still, if it makes her happy, I guess I can do it.
What's that, number 2?
I didn't say nothing.
The local extension team was just high for the whole game when translating this shit because, well.
Oh, that was fun. That was the best rampage ever. Here now, have some water. Thanks.
Precious, you certainly took it up another notch today. It's a good thing we're in such an isolated spot here.
But yeah, can you imagine me running amok in the middle of town?
A grim thought indeed. Listen, I have a theory that we need to rampage. I think there are a way for your downside to get some exercise.
Yeah, could it be? Is exercise something you humans do a lot?
Most of us, yes. It's a great way to get rid of stress and blow off steam. The healers say regular exercise is the key to good health.
Do you up fruit trees?
No, not usually. In fact, almost never.
Oh, that's too bad. Uprooting trees is my favorite bit.
Also, the other day in the village, I saw a lady screaming at her husband. She was chasing him around the square with this huge crawling thing. Then she went in the house, threw his stuff out of the window and stomped on it. Was that exercise? Because it should look like I would work out. No, that's something different, although I wager she was blowing off steam.
Well, it seems that my exercise needs to be destructive. I can't stop until I've splintered some trees or turn up a shred of underground.
It's a good thing we have plenty of forest to spare.
Oh, and I feel much better running amok if you're here with me.
Because I can make sure that you don't destroy anything important.
Because forests are that serious and have lots of cost. But when you're around, I know they scare one little bit. Sometimes I forget there's a little girl inside that monstrous beast. So you are going to keep coming with me for my exercises, aren't you? Of course, I've grown quite fond of them, and of you. You're like the little sister I never have, and I guess the big monster I never had to. Yay! Grand Brady.
Then Ma pulls out a little umbrella of hers and she says, "What are you laughing for, right? I ain't even at the punchline yet.
I'm just glad we're able to talk like this, Brady. I'll admit, I was a little shocked when I first saw you. You seem a bit scary."
"Yeah, well, sorry I'm not scary. I guess if you don't like it, do a better rough job raising the real deal."
"What, you mean the Brady from this era?"
"Yeah, I ain't your real son anyway. I mean, not exactly."
"Brady, I..."
"Well, what? What's with that face? I don't need your pity. Like some of the other kids, I am the jealous of the Brady from this time. We're two different cats, yeah? No hard feelings. Was the real once born. You can forget about me. I'll bow out or grace for like."
Brady, how can you say that after we've gotten so close? You think I just cast you aside when my son is born? I would never do that. You're my friend, Brady, and my son.
Poop, I... Oh, damn. I decided not to cry. Then you go and say crap like that. I was lying about what I said before, Pop. It does matter to me. Please don't forget me. Just remember that we were good pals once, yeah? Real champs.
I could never forget you, son. Remember you till the day I die, and love you as my future self.
Okay, no more talk of that. If you go boots up before me, I'll douse your grave in more tea than you can stand. I'll play my violin and do a backflip if I have to. Don't try me, old-timer.
Well, then it's settled. Guess your pop can't very well die now, can he? Okay. Tuna supports to... Lauren Severa, okay, Tiki's up there. Lauren Severa. I guess I still can't believe it. Severa? Oh, hello. Look, Dex, the company must have thanked you as well, then. Yes, it's been a total parade of praise ever since the two of us went shopping. Kom has even searched me out just to offer his compliments. Has been almost surreal, especially in his... bite of our prior arguments. Seems we managed to strike a perfect balance. Nothing missed, nothing wasted. Nothing missing, nothing wasted. People have been especially excited over the most extraneous items. That has to feel pretty good as the guy responsible for the shopping, but yet. Yes, though, I would have never thought to purchase half of what they mentioned. Not to fit appear wasteful to my eye, but it seems you have the right of it. I apologize for doubting your selection. Oh, it's fine. Besides, I'd have spent twice as much if you hadn't made me think about the excesses. Someone else aside, you really are good with numbers and you always stay on task. Thank you. Praise from you is a rare treat indeed. Suppose this means that together we were able to do what neither could alone. Yeah, for all our arguing, we actually make a pretty good team. I would welcome your help again in the next procurement. If you wouldn't mind joining me, that is. As long as you promise to let me handle the fruit, I'm there. Very good. And now Tiki. Only B for now. Tiki, I'm ready to hear the story now. Oh, yes, I did promise, didn't I? I'm feeling very tired at the moment. Can it wait? Okay, what about tomorrow? Yes, thank you, I'd appreciate that. So... do you snooze so much because you slept for thousands of years? I don't know. I suppose I do sleep a little more than most people. You sure do? Iggy? What is it now? I thought we agreed to talk another day. No, the history lesson can wait. It's just... there's something else. What is it? When you turn into a dragon, well, your ears are bigger than mine.
Yes, I suppose they. Why is that? It's because I am pure-blooded. When I get blood runs thick in my veins and make me look more dragon-like. Is that why, also why your fangs and claws are sharper than mine? No, that is a matter only of age. I have lived many, many more centuries than you. As dragons get older and become more powerful, our claws and fangs sharpen. It will be the same for you when you reach my age, though it would take millennia. That would be sweet. See, so why is your skin so much thicker and harder than mine? That comes for fighting in countless battles. The more times a dragon is struck by blows, the thicker and harder our hide becomes. See, that's useful. Thanks for explaining everything, Tiki. Not at all. But would you mind leaving me now? I'm starting to feel drowsy. Oh, of course. Sleep well, Tiki. See you again soon. Questions upon questions. I suppose I'll have to tell her soon. Okay. Yeah. Well, no point in saving here. I guess I will save once I... Chapter 24, Awakening. I hope I can at least fit a little bit of gameplay in the first part of the video, because this video is for sure going to be a two-parter. Yeah, this background. It's beautiful. The divine dragon's power flows through every blade of grass here. Which something doesn't feel right. You must prepare for battle. We must send servants here. I can sense it. They'll be on us soon. So as I said in the previous part, this chapter has always felt like filler to me. Because you battle a lot of mounted enemies in a forest. The boss is a reason with a tomahawk. I don't know. The map is supposed to be original, and it's one of the few instances in Awakening where you actually see a good amount of terrain, but I don't think the terrain is well used. It's just a big map with forest, but the forest doesn't really matter because you have a lot of flyers and the ranges overlap, so you still have to do the battle royale style of battling enemies that you are used to in this game. Who did I want to leave behind? Yeah, Donnell. Because Donnell is level 20, didn't have enough money to buy him a second seal, so what I do now is just I want to be able to buy a second seal and still buy grinding, you know, wrecking boxes. So I'm going to leave Donnell behind and bring the rest of the people. So we can begin already. How could reason infiltrate this sacred place? Their power must be linked to Grimms. We must destroy them. Yeah, so the enemies aren't relevant. The map is kind of difficult, but at the same time doesn't make sense because I think you get reinforcements from the forts. And it always makes me think, okay, so does that mean that there are reason... How can reinforcements come from the fort when these are reason? These are the enemies of... Like, they shouldn't be in this place, so why are they so used to this place and getting reinforcements from this place? It would make much more sense if the enemies came from behind, because, you know, Grima has sent more recent. Anyway. Yeah, and as I said, the terrain isn't really relevant, but that doesn't keep it from being annoying. Yeah, okay, I can just leave the PR here. Okay. I forgot to take the hammers. Well, have a Thoron here. I enter this range. Okay, have a silver bow, so no players here. Oh! I just use the health swath. Okay. Super, I want to do that? No. Think. Nah. He's the one that wants to enter here and just battle you. Can keep the axe. I will one shot you. 2 uses on the normal Dragonstone. Okay. I'm also going to trade you the silver bow. Okay. Have 2 of my healers up there. Everybody's going to come down in the end. Is this... Okay, this is just the silver axe range, so... I'll battle with the soul. Yeah, and the falcon is good too. This is a sword, right? Yes, so I don't have the lan- Oh yeah, I have lances, I have Frederick. Okay. A rally. Yeah, I should do well. I don't think... Yeah, they are level 16, but I have many capped stats on my units. Like, yeah, you see. Nat takes 0 damage. 0 damage. I know I've been training her a lot, but still, if the game expects me to train... But I guess the game doesn't necessarily expect you to train. Right? Yeah. Maybe that's the thing. Maybe I'm playing Awakening wrong. Okay. Level 16. And the worst part is, Na gains experience very fast. And she's still getting more speed and more. Yeah, and that was the normal Dragonstone. Not even the good one. Also, another thing that makes this map stupid. Why bother having a formation on your enemies if they are all going to start moving? Like, only a while after we start. Anyway, this is the flyer. So we have 2 flyers here. The mages and... Do you... Okay, here's our Excalibur. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so first of all, kill you. I got a spear. Oh, we get the spears? Do we get good droppables in this map? Tomahawk. Okay. A medium bullion and a Thoron. Should have remembered that before. Okay. Is this the most focus I can get? I still feel like I'm a bit far. Okay. Okay, then I guess I will have to throw some of the short axes I have on my people. Also can't reach you. So I guess you're out of my way for this turn. I think you're okay like this. If they actually... This is a good pair up too. You probably die easily with the DPR. Level 5 for Maribel. So that's rally resistance. Yeah, I'm throwing resistance plus 2 for that. Excalibur. Didn't check your range, but I'm pretty sure I'm out of it. Yes. Okay. Flyers may come for Tsubasa, but she should be okay. So I'm out of your range. That's good. Can I one-shot you? Not without... I mean, we're at the point of the game where I can use some of my 30 uses without fear of running out of uses before endgame, right? Yeah, your fell doesn't really serve a purpose here. However, using the bolt axe against you sounds good. Yes. And... okay, Silverlands. Dead. Level 8 for kill. Good level. Good level. That's a good level. Separate you there. Yeah. Come on. Do your worst. Yeah, I still think Tsubasa is going to be okay because there's only Tomahawk. Definitely giving that to someone after the map is over. Miriel can't be reached by anyone else. Yeah, we may have gone a little bit overkill. And yeah, just a silver lance is enough. Kill you. This game is really the definition of no balance. Like, the more I think about it, it's a game that allows itself to have sudden spikes of difficulty because, well, after all, you could always go train, so you don't have a reason to... Yeah, like, you can't really say, oh, this map is too difficult, I'm not going to be able to do it, because after all, you're able to go outside and training. But then, when you train, the places where you train are normally lower level than your story chapter, so in the end, training trivializes the game. Which maybe was the point, maybe the whole point of Awakening was just having the ultimate power fantasy. You know what I mean by power fantasy. Have a game where you just kill everything and are able to overcome everything. But okay, I think maybe I blocked one by putting Tsubasa there. Yeah, that wasn't very effective as reinforcements. Let me send you home with that killer bow. Perfect. Not much else was needed. We will take this fort now. Brady can come here. Or we can come there. So, yeah, ruin. Glass axe. Useful. Okay, we're just outside of your range. And I guess we're outside of everyone's range. So, oh, yeah, the flyer survived. Going to separate. Don't have acrobat still on Gaius, and this definitely was the map for acrobat. I want to heal you back. Then sit ups, that's experience, right? Bit wasted because you were already 96. And this is not, yeah, this is only silver sword range, so I think I want to drop now and stay here with a lance, because that's a sword. Yeah, I think that's all. Okay, more reinforcement. I don't think you're able to kill Bike. Maybe the both of you are able to kill Gaius. Oh, okay. Could have been dangerous. It's okay. The boss is moving. Did we provoke him or is it because of the turn? I don't know. Well, recover. I love the trickster animation for healing, like the sprite where he raises the sword towards the person that he's healing. I love it. I wish I could weaken him before. Okay, maybe I can, yeah, can attack with Tiki, then kill with Stahl. Because Stahl doesn't have as high a level as I would like. It's only level 3 Paladin, and I know he looped up to 15 Swordmaster, but feel bad about not giving him even level 5. Okay, I can kill the boss easily. I'm not going to even give you the... Oh, only use one, because they join. So allies can join in the middle of an attack. Okay. And I think I'm going to kill you with the toehold going. There are no chests, no nothing. No. Okay. Easy map. Naga Nemesis, you will never... You have Luna! But I don't think that matter. That was plus 15 damage, because Luna is... Ignore half health, so plus... Could have been very bad. We will never know. Now I'm taking care of the heroes. Oh. This background. Okay, don't remember this one.
Yes.
We've made it, the altar, wait here. We'll be back. Be careful, girl. You must be leaving him, Aunt Lisa. Hear me, Naga. I bear proof of our sacred covenant. In the name of the exalted blood, I ask for the divine dragon's power. Baptize me in fire so that I may become your true son. Here is she. Ugh. Father, I'm alright. Be welcome, awakener. Your heart has been tested and deemed worthy. Cleansed by my fire, your desire has proven to burn the stronger. Then you will grant me the power to defeat Grima? The power of a god? Yes, but know this. I am no god. But, Lady, you are the divine dragon. So do sons of man name me. But I am no creator. I possess not the powers of making or unmaking. And neither does Grima. Neither of us bears the power to destroy the other utterly. Then, what power can you grant me? With my blessing, thou may draw forth Fankion's true might for only 2 fucking chapters. The blade of the exiles shall again strike like the dragon fang. Your strength will then be my equal. But not strong enough to destroy Grima? Alas, Grima cannot be slain. Sleep alone can be your victory. Just as your ancestor put the fell dragon to sleep a millennium ago. But you must weaken him first. Only as the final blow can my power be used to bind his. Isn't there any way to strengthen Fallwood? There's perchance a power that could end Grima. However, it would be his own. He has to kill himself? Yes. Never would he do so of his own volition. He seeks only to add to his power and set ruin upon the world. Now come, There is little time for screaming. To the west lies a volcano known as Origin Peak. You shall find the fell dragon there. Exalted Falcon. Oh no, no closing story. So I guess we're about to finish. That's chapter 25. I'm definitely training up to level 15. As I said, I don't care if I trivialize. I just want to say I trained everyone to the point they were stupidly broken in this save. And yeah, by getting counter, for example, I know it's not needed, but it's 7 levels, so why not? Still getting ages. I'm just going to go full on for the absolute abuse of power. I got an arms scroll, used it on Gaius, that's why his staves are looking well now. Trained weapons on Tiki. Everyone has A on almost every rank. I'm pretty happy about how this team ended up in the end. But let's give it a last push because before we call this over. Next part will be chapter 25, Origin Peak, which is the preface of the endgame, Grima. But for now, this has been Pomon. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, and I will see you in the next part. Bye.